Hello students, welcome back for a new video. In previous class we have already studied what are the classes that are handling that are used for handling events. Okay, so we have studied in previous class the classes action event, adjustment event. Action event class is when it is when button is pressed or item list is double clicked or menu item is selected, and different event classes for handling events, right? Now today we are going to study event listener interfaces. See, these classes and interfaces are working together to handle an event. So these are the interfaces that are defined by Java for handling events. Okay, so here you will see that action listener, adjustment listener, component listener, container listener, same as these classes. See, action event, action listener, adjustment event, adjustment listener, component event, component listener, right? So with respect to the classes, they have developed respective interfaces. Okay, what I have told you that interfaces means they will have just method definition, right? Method definition without a body. It doesn't have any body. And once an interface is declared, we need to implement this interface in our code, and we need to write the body for the method defined in that interface, right? So these listeners are under a package java.awt.event. This means whenever you are writing a code, you need to import this package. Then only you are able to write the body for respective interfaces. And see, these interfaces that you are seeing are used for different purposes. Like action listener interface is used for buttons, lists. Okay, and adjustment listener is used for adjustment values like your scroll bar. Okay, and all. So mouse listener interface will be used for your mouse wheel event. See, mouse wheel listener interface will be used for your mouse wheel event. Mouse motion listener will be used for mouse motion events, and mouse listener will be used for recognizing click enters a component, exited the component, press or release. And this mouse motion listener is for dragging and moved whenever you're moving your mouse. See, this is moving your mouse, and dragging means like this. See, this is dragging. Okay, I will see the first action listener. Okay, then how it is going to work, I will tell you. Now first action listener, this interface, action listener interface, defines only one method. See, action listener interface, this interface defines action performed method, only one method it is defining, that is invoked when an action event is occurred. Whenever an event is generated for a specific component, here we are talking about, suppose, buttons. Okay, whenever a button is clicked, it will be invoked. Which method will be invoked? Action performed method will be invoked. Means, it is defined under action listener interface, means it doesn't have any body. So who is going to write the body? We are going to write the body. Means when I click on a button, what should happen? What should happen? Okay, that you are writing under the body of this action performed class. Let's see the syntax of this action performed method. Okay, let's see the syntax of action performed method. Syntax of action performed method is, it is just void, returning void, and it is taking one parameter, and the parameter is object of action event class. Let's take a scenario that I have a button. See, now I will take one frame. In that I have one button, only one button. I will resize it. See, okay, this button, this much big button. So I will write something here, exit. Okay, so this button is displaying with a label exit. Now when I run this code, it will not respond you because I don't have any action listener for that. Okay, so what I'm doing is I'm adding an action listener to this. This is a button, so events, I'm going for action event. In that, I am going to write the body for action performed. See, action performed. So if you see here, my cursor is moved to here. Button variable was J button one, action performed, and it is taking the object of action event class. What I need to do, I need to write here what my button should do. So what I'm writing is system dot exit with a status zero. With a status zero. Whenever I press this button, the entire application should close. Okay. So if I run this code, so whenever I click this, it is performing an action. And what action it is performing? It is performing exit action. So what is actually happening? See, whenever a user clicks on a button, okay, internally, suppose our button that we had in example, this button, okay, this button, exit button, okay. Actually, what is happening? When you click the button, Java internally developed a respective object of a respective event. So we have clicked a button, right? We have clicked a button. For button, what was the event? Action event class. This is generated when a button is pressed. So action event class object will be created. Action event class object will be created. See, the object is created. See, it is not necessary that the name always should be AE. So it can be, for your understanding purpose, I have taken entire statement. Actually, it is executing only this. So internally, Java will create a action event class object, and it will transfer to action performed method. See, it will transfer to action performed method. Then in the body, we are going to write what we need to do when this button was pressed. Okay, and you will see the response, whatever that you have written in the body, onto your screen. Okay, so actually the event dictionary is the method called action perform whose body you have written. You have written means you need to write a class which is going to implement action listener interface, and it is going to write that class. In that class, you are going to write the body of action performed method. Right, and action performed method is taking action event class object as a parameter. It is same like your exception handling. In exception handling, whenever exceptional condition arises, a object representing that exception is thrown, and it will be caught by catch clause. Right, same. Whenever event is generated, a object representing that event, a particular event. So in this case, it was button. So that's why it has generated action event class, action event object. Okay, so it will be created by Java automatically, and it will be thrown. Whenever you are throwing it, someone should catch it. So action performed has caught that action event class. See, simply it will not catch. See, in exception handling, if you just throw, or Java throws an exception, it will just catch, right? Here what happens is, this method must and should be registered with the source. Registered with the source that we have already seen in the beginning of this event. See, a source generates an event and sends it to one or more listeners. Once an event is received, okay, here in delegation event model, listener must register with a source in order to receive event notification. Same thing. See here, this was a listener. This listener must and should register itself to the source. So for registering, which method we are using? See, if you have watched my previous videos, in that I have explained that we need to use add type listener method. Here type will be replaced by a particular event, particular listener interface, particular listener interface. In both the cases, in this type as well as in this type. See, so it should register itself to the source through add action listener. See here, what I'm doing is, this music is a object, means it's a button name. Button name dot add. Here it should be type actually, right? Here it should be type. Type, what type of event it is? It is action event. So action listener. Again, the syntax of that method was here. was type, right? So type will be replaced with type of event. The type of event is action event. See, type will be replaced by action, right? So in this again, type will be replaced by action. Understood? So first it should register. Once it has registered, whenever a event is generated, it is creating an object of that particular event that describes the event, then it is thrown, then a particular method which has already registered to this source will get that object and perform some actions. Okay, so we have already seen that this action event is a class, right? Action event is a class. Action event is a class. So it will have many methods here. You can obtain a command name of an invoking action event object by using a get action command method. So this is actually defined under action event class. Action event class. Get action command. I have told you that in HTML, whenever you are having a button or a tag, for that we are giving a ID, right? That ID can be a string or integer. In Java, that ID will be declared as a string here. Okay, so object address is passed here, right? So here you can use that class methods also. So AE dot get action command. Get action command. It is returning a string value. So you can store under a string variable. Understood? So still you are having a liberty of writing your own code, and you can use the methods defined by action event class. Both together you can use under action performed methods body. Understood? So rest of the interfaces I'm not going to explain actually. No need to explain actually. See, because adjustment event class. In adjustment event class. We'll see adjustment event class. See, this is adjustment event class. In that adjustment event class, we have studied block decrement, block increment, type of events, that is track, unit decrement, unit increment, right? The same methods we are going to use. Same methods. See, in adjustment listener class. Adjustment value changed. The value changed to unit or to block or track or to it has been dragged or what. Okay, so it declares only one method called adjustment value changed. After that we have component listener interface, and this component listener interface is for component event class. See, component event class. What component event class was containing? Component hidden, component shown, component moved, component resized. According to that type of event, the methods will be declared. See here, component event listener interface. See, component resized, component moved, component shown, component hidden, same methods, which will take component event class as a object. As a object to the argument of, as a argument of component event methods. See, component resized is a method which takes a argument of component event class. Okay, now moving to container listener interface. Okay, container listener interface, we had any container event class? Yes, we had container event class. In that container event class, we had component added and component removed, that I have already explained you in the previous video. See, container listener, component added, component removed methods. Okay, for these two methods, you need to write the body, and it takes container event class object as a argument. Same. Next is focus listener interface. In that we have focus gained and focus lost, and it will take focus event class object as a argument. Then next, item listener interface. So we had this item event class. See, item event class, right? In that item event class we had, see, item event class we had key event and mouse events, right? So in this we have item event class. Okay, sorry, item listener interface. Okay, item listener interface. We has item state changed, that it has been, the state value has been changed from selected to non-selected value, or non-selected to selected value, right? Then key listener interface, key pressed, key released, key typed, same as the type of event in key event class. Then mouse listener interface, mouse listener interface will have mouse clicked, mouse entered, mouse exited, mouse pressed, mouse released, okay? And it takes mouse event as a mouse event object as a argument. Mouse motion listener, mouse dragged and mouse moved. Then mouse wheel listener interface. Mouse wheel listener interface will have mouse wheel moved. Okay, and it will take mouse wheel event as object as a argument. Then we had text event class. In that, I have given you example of Google text bar, right? Here, same thing, we have text value changed. See, text changed, and it takes text event class object as a argument. Okay, Windows focus listener interface, focus gained or focus lost, and it takes Windows event class object as a argument. Then Windows had active window, open window, closed window, closing window, deactivated window, deiconified window, iconified window. If you have studied those classes, you will easily understand the interfaces. Okay, now after that, how to use these classes and interfaces to handle a mouse events. Okay, to handle a mouse events, we'll see. So to handle mouse events, what we need, see, we are not talking about mouse wheel listeners, we are talking about mouse events. So in mouse events, we have only mouse listener interface and mouse motion listener interface. Okay, so this means you need to implement these two interfaces for handling mouse events. Okay, these two interfaces for handling mouse events, and you are going to write the body for all these methods, all these methods. So in your textbook, you have a code for this handling mouse events on page number 654. See here. So here I'm having a public class mouse event. I'm not talking about these imports. Okay, we'll see these imports when it will be used. So first, a public class mouse events, just you are declaring a class called mouse events that extends applet. What is this applet actually? Applet is a small piece of code which will run on a web browser or a applet viewer. Okay, you can create JFrame also. See how I have created a frame here. See, this is a frame, right? If you go to the code of this, you will see that new frame extends JFrame. Okay, so instead of frame, I am using applet. I am using applet. The author is using here applet. Applet is a kind of front view. Okay, front view. Now, whenever you are creating an applet, you need to extend, you need to create a class which should extend applet. Whenever you need to create a frame, at that time, you need to create a class which should extend a frame. Okay, so same thing here, you are creating applet, so you are extending an applet. Implements, you need to implement which interfaces you are handling mouse events, right? So you need to implement mouse listener interface and mouse motion listener interface. These two you need to implement. Means you are not going to write the bodies for these five methods as well as for these two methods. See, implements mouse listener interface and mouse motion listener. Now here we are having two variables. One is msg, which is of type string and is initialized to nothing, and we are having another two variables, mouse y and mouse x. Both those are initialized to zero and both are of type integer. We'll see. Okay, whenever you are creating an applet, applet has its own skeleton, its own structure. Like you have a C program, if you have a C program has its own skeleton, its own general format, that you should have a global declarations, then you should have a main, then you should have a local declaration, some functions, right? Like this, here whenever you are creating an applet, you should write a body of a init method. You need to write a body for init method. Init, what actually it is doing, init method is to write some initial settings. Okay, what we are doing is, in this actually, what we are doing is, see, we are actually creating a window, applet window. Okay, you are creating applet window by extending applet class. Now the applet window name is mouse events. Okay, now in this you are adding these two listeners, that is here this window itself is a source. This window that you are seeing now, this window itself is a source which will generate a events. Okay, which will generate a event. So whenever you are creating a applet window and you are adding a listener to this, so this window is going to generate events and particular listeners is going to receive this events, and they are going to execute the body of particular methods. Okay, particular methods. So what you have done is entire window considering as a source of event, you are adding mouse listener as well as mouse motion listener in, you are registering with that window. Okay, in previous case what I had this window, on that window I had a button was registered to the particular listener, right? Whenever I run this, see, button was registered. So when I click on this outside area, it will not respond back because I have not registered this window with any of the listeners. I have just registered this component with action event class, right? So that's why it is going to respond me and the window is not responding me. So what we are doing is for entire window, we are adding these two listeners. We are adding two listeners means wherever you click on this window, it is going to respond back to you. Okay, we'll see how practically. Once you have added these listeners to this window, you need to write the body for mouse clicked. See, starts with mouse clicked. Mouse clicked. Okay, when you click a mouse, what should happen? When you click a mouse and the mouse clicked event will take mouse event object as an argument, right? See, mouse event object as an argument. It is not necessary that it should be always ME. It can be M, M, E, E or anything. User declared. So when mouse is clicked, what you need to do? You are setting your mouse X and Y, means coordinates of a mouse. See, when my mouse is here, so this should have a coordinate. See, my mouse is here on the height. Okay, height. So this should have a coordinate. I'm not going to explain this because it is not necessary when you are running in NetBeans. If you are separately running through Java command, then you need to have this code in HTML file. So it's not necessary. No need to study this. Okay. Now, if I go to a particular position, so this is my cursor now. What is the coordinate of this cursor? You can get through mouse X and mouse Y. What we are doing, once you are clicking on that window anywhere, you are just setting your X coordinate to 0 and Y coordinate to 10 and certain message to mouse clicked. Actually, that mouse was clicked. Then you are calling repaint. So actually this repaint is a method of applet, and repaint will call paint, and again it is following the syntax of applet. See, applet skeleton is what a applet should have. See, whenever you are creating an applet first must and should have init method to write some initial preferences or settings. Then it should have start, then it should have paint, then stop, then destroy. Okay, if you are not writing start or init also, no problem. If you don't write init also, no problem. But the thing is you are not getting your settings, you will get Java's settings, default settings. Okay, now you are having your own settings, that for entire window you need to have these two listeners registered. So how to register, we have already seen. Add type of listener, here mouse type. So then another type is mouse motion type listener. Now mouse clicked, repaint. Repaint will call paint, right? Repaint will call paint. This is what, how applet works. Whenever you call repaint, repaint will call paint. And you are going to write the body for paint. In paint, what you are doing? G dot draw string. What is this G actually? Paint will take one argument called graphics G. Graphics G. See, actually, in previous syllabus, we had applet class. But for you, they have already removed this applet class. Okay. So, if you want to understand what are applets, you can study applet chapter in the Java textbook. Okay. Then you can come here. So, for this time being, actually, applet has five methods. Init, start, paint, stop, destroy. Okay. Here we are going to override only two methods, and those are init and paint. Init and paint. Okay, so init already we have seen. So whenever you are calling repaint, it will call paint. It will call paint. And paint will take graphic class object as an argument, and this graphic class has a method called drawString. Has a method called drawString. That's why g.drawString message. DrawString method, what it will do is, it will write things on the screen. See, you are using system.out.println for console outputs, right? Here we are using drawString for displaying something on screen. Displaying something on screen means draw something on a screen. See, drawString, what string we need to draw? We need to draw message. MSG, what was the message when mouse was clicked? Mouse clicked. This message we need to write on these coordinates, see, on this value. Let me show you. I have already run this program. See, whenever I click, mouse click. You can see here, mouse click. See, if I press mouse click on this location, so it was actually, the code was actually written like this, right? Mouse clicked on this coordinate, you need to print this message. So if I change the coordinate, suppose if I change the coordinate from 10 to 0 to 10, okay, and this coordinate to something 50, okay, let me see if I run this code, what will happen. See, if I click, see, now the message was displayed here, mouse clicked, right? So see, mouse clicked here, previously it was displaying here, right? So this was 10 pixels X direction and 50 pixels Y direction. See, if I change again, change it to some different value, 50 and 100. If you run it, see, whenever I click on mouse, mouse click on different location, right? So we have seen code for mouse click. See, we have only written up to mouse click, then entered, exited, press, release, mouse drag, mouse moved. This we need to write. See, when mouse enter, what we need to display? We need to display mouse entered on this coordinate. Call repaint. Repaint will print that thing. See, mouse entered. You can see on the screen. On the screen, you can see mouse entered. When I exit this mouse, outside this window, you will see here mouse exited. See. Mouse exited, right? So when my mouse is exited on this location, you need to print mouse exited. Okay, mouse pressed. Okay, whenever I press and hold my mouse button, press and hold my mouse button, what it should do? Display down. Okay, see here, it should display a message called down, but not on 0 and 10. It should display on a particular coordinates, and you are getting here me.getX. me.getX mouse event was a class which is having different methods, and one of the methods that you are going to study is me was an object name. me.getX, getX means this method will retrieve X coordinate, X value of a screen, and this method will retrieve Y value. That's why whenever I'm clicking here, it's showing you down. Okay, when I click here, it will show you down on that particular coordinate. See, down particular coordinate, right? See, it is when mouse was pressed. When mouse was released, see here, when I clicked this mouse, down. Since suddenly I'm releasing, you will see here up. See, when mouse are released, you need to have up, but on different coordinates, not on 0 and 10. See, down, then I release up, right? Particular coordinates. When I drag a mouse means what? You need to press and hold the button, then you need to drag, move around that window. See, this was a window. Now, I have already pressed my button. Now I'm dragging. See, you will see a star lurking around on the screen. See, star on the screen, right? Moving on the screen, right? You will see the values too. Mouse, dragging mouse at 135, 123, 215. See, my coordinate along with the coordinates. Star along with the coordinates. See, mouse dragged. You need to display star. And in the status bar, show status. So this is actually status bar. Status bar. What is the status bar? See, whenever you have this Google Chrome, when you try to connect to Google, you will have a status bar here. See, on the screen. On the screen, you will have a status bar. When you go to YouTube, see, you will have a status bar here, right? So here status bar. So connecting to google.com, you might have seen. And that is called status bar. Now, whenever I'm dragging the mouse, see, dragging mouse at these locations. See? So you are showing in the status, dragging mouse at whatever the value that you have got in the real time. Okay? That it is displaying on the screen. Right? Then mouse moved. See, on this window, if I move my mouse, again, you are seeing on the status, moving mouse at these coordinates. See? Mouse moved. Show status, moving mouse at me.getx, me.getY. Then here you are not calling repaint. Why? Why? Because we are not displaying any message on the screen. We are displaying the messages on show status. That's why we need not to call repaint. See, we are not displaying anything. When I'm moving my mouse, we are not displaying anything on this canvas, white canvas. We are displaying only the information on this status bar. Understood how this mouse event you have handled? Please open your NetBeans and practice. Otherwise, you are not going to understand. You need to study. See, we are in a lockdown situation, so it is very difficult to teach you these things through videos. If we could have classes, I have explained you all the applet classes and all, and properly you have understood what to write and what not to write. Okay, so sorry for this inconvenience. So if you have any doubts, you can contact me about this mouse event, handling mouse event class. Okay, so for handling keyboard event also, we have different program. Now you can study this program on page number 657 for handling keyboard events. Okay, it's very simple. See, if it is a keyboard events, you need to have key listener interface. You need to implement just key listener interface, the same thing that they are doing see here they are implementing key listener interface, and they are creating a class which extends an applet. In it, they are just adding the entire screen as a source and adding key listener interface. Okay, and they are having some MSGs to initialize to something, then coordinates to 10 and 20. So whenever you are pressing a key on a keyboard, it is showing you key down. Press and hold a key, it will show you key down in the status bar and key up in the status bar. And whenever you type something, it will show you, see, a message. Message is equal to message plus. Message is equal to message plus. Okay, means the previous message. Or if you don't want message equal to message plus, the message that you want to type, that message it will show you. So I will run that code I have here. So see, we had just, let me change the value from message is equal to message plus to only message. Okay, see, only message. If you have this only message, okay, let it be message plus. Message is equal to message plus. So whatever the things you are typing, it will be attached to the previous string. Now I need to write here Kalmesh. Now Kalmesh. Kalmesh. Okay, this is how actually text editor works. So what you are doing is you are first typing K. So K will be there in your MSG. Then again you are typing A. So whatever was actually present in MSG, MSG actually was having previously K, right? Then you are again attaching to the same message, previous message. Message is equal to message plus get the next key. Get the character of next key. Then I have pressed A. That's why you are seeing KA together. Okay. See? Kalmesh. Now, if I write Jayvant. See? Jayvant. Then suddenly I write space. Okay. Again space. Then Dhania. Okay. Dhania. Okay, see, whenever a key I have pressed here, suppose I have pressed a space button, you will see in the status window key down. See, key down, right? When I release, key up. Understood? This program you can study by yourself. If you have any doubt, you can contact me. Okay, in the next class, we are going to study, in the next video, we are going to study adapter classes, inner classes, and anonymous inner classes. And these are a little bit difficult. Okay, if you have any doubts, you can contact me. Till next video, stay home, stay safe.